Hi students, from today onwards we are going to start the first chapter of class 9, that is measurement and experimentation. Okay, the thing is how this idea measurement and experimentation is coming out. For to understand this, let us start from the topic physics. Okay, physics, it means what? Physics means as branch of science. That is, we already know it. But what is studying in physics? In physics, we are mainly studying dealing with the nature and natural phenomena. Okay, means nature and natural phenomena, it means what? In our surrounding, we are just saying that means how the day and night are making, how the earth is revolving around the sun. Okay, like I am giving you one example here, why sky is blue during daytime. These are all natural phenomena. But in physics, how it is happen, from where it comes, this is going to be studied in physics. Okay, for to study those things, we divide the quantity that is going to be considered, that is going to study, okay, into two types. One is physical quantity and one is non-physical quantity. Okay, and here the point is, which kind of quantity is going to consider as physical quantity and which kind of quantity is going to consider as non-physical quantity. It means, let's see, physical quantity mainly says those quantity which can be measured directly, yeah, or indirectly. Okay, but in non-physical quantity, it says those quantity which can't be measured. Okay, for to understand these two quantities, I am giving you example here. Like, I am trying to find out the length of a pipe. I am trying to find out the length of a pipe. Okay, the length of the pipe is given here 4 meter. Means for to find out the length of the pipe, of that pipe, okay, you are going to using meter tape, yeah, meter rule, for to find out the length. Means that is the direct method. Okay, but in indirect method, how we can say we are trying to find out the area, we are trying to find out the volume. For to finding the area and volume, first you are going to find out length, breadth, height. After finding all these things, you can find out the volume. If you are finding out the length, breadth, then you can find area by multiplying the both two quantities. Okay, that is the indirect method. And again, I say non-physical quantity. In non-physical quantity, which is going to be considered? In non-physical quantity, like I can say which can be measured. Like today I'm saying I miss all my students. That is the emotion. Okay, I'm just expressing that is my emotion. That emotion can't be expressed. If it can't be expressed, how can we study? Okay, that is included in the non-physical quantity. Okay, now just remind this physical quantity, non-physical quantity. Okay. For to study, what to say, this physical quantity, for to more study about this physical quantity, we need measurement. Okay, in measurement, let's see, measurement means what? Measurement means comparison of any physical quantity with what? The non-standard quantity of same nature. With a non-standard quantity, it means what? Here, standard quantity mainly it says it is the unit. It is the unit. Okay, means when you are trying to find out, I am here giving example, mass of the body is 4 kg. Here, mass, it is the physical quantity. Okay, for to measure this mass, you are going to express here 4 kg. Kg is the standard unit. Okay. Unit means when you are trying to find out measurement of any quantity, of any physical quantity, you are going to use any standard unit. okay, so that you can get the value of that means quantity. Okay, here I also give the reason need for measurement. Why it is needed for measurement? For the proper study of any physical phenomena. Means here from the beginning, why we are studying? For to study those physical phenomena. If we can measure those physical phenomena, then we can precisely explain about how the phenomena are happening. Okay, that's why it is essential to make measurement in the physical quantities involved. Okay, means like see here, if when you are going to consider those physical phenomena, means some physical quantities are going to be involved. Okay, means I am giving one example here. Like when I study about the scattering of light, at a time you will see the symbol lambda. Okay, lambda means here lambda is lambda wavelength. It is a wavelength symbol. Okay, for to find out wavelength, okay, you are going to study about means here wavelength is like you can say when you are going to find out the length of that wavelength, you are going to express in the form of unit like meter. Means that is the physical quantity like length. The physical quantity that you are using is length. Okay, here means I say when you are going to do measurement, okay, that physical quantity which is involved in that physical phenomena, we are trying to measure it. If you can measure it, then you can precisely study about that phenomena. Okay, now we have discussed up to this one. Again, here the term unit also coming out. Unit is what? I say it is the standard quantity of constant magnitude which is used to measure the magnitude of any physical quantity having same nature. Okay, for to understand this one, let us again see this example. Mass of the body is 4 kg. Okay, here the unit used is 4 kg. 4 kg. Kg is the unit for to express the physical quantity mass. Okay, mass here it, we are just using it physical quantity. Okay, and this unit can express here, you see kg is the unit, and in before this unit we are expressing the value, some value 4, and because of this what to say, you can express what to say in that physical quantity how many times that unit is contained. Okay, that is given here. I say means standard quantity of constant magnitude which is used to measure the magnitude of any physical quantity. This is the magnitude, okay, of that physical quantity, what? Mass. And I discuss up to here, and we have some idea about unit also. Like when you are going to choose the unit, it should have some property. Okay, like means for choosing the unit, it should have some property, like, you know, it should be acceptable everywhere, and it should not change when the physical conditions are changed. Means physical conditions are changed, it means what? Like you can say when the temperature are changing, the unit sense, no, it's not going to be like that. Okay, it should be constant, and it should be acceptable everywhere. It means what? Means in India it will be the value of this one is will be this one, in what is it, in other countries it should be like this. No, it should be acceptable, it should be internationally acceptable. Okay, that is the property for choosing the unit. And now we are going to study about the physical quantity. When you are going to express this physical quantity, we need two parameters. One is numerical value and one is what? Unit. Here it is unit, and one is another one is numerical value. Means for to express the physical quantity, we need two quantities. One is numerical value and another is unit. Okay, see, for to understand this one, again I just give example. Length of the cloth is 4 meter. Here meter is what? Meter is the unit, and 4 is the magnitude, means numerical value, and m is the unit. Okay, here 4 meter express the physical quantity value, length. Okay, And I am just doing like, you know, 4 meter. When I am just going to convert into another unit centimeter, it's going to be 400 centimeter. Okay, see, I am just trying to give you one important point here. When you are changing meter to centimeter, which one is bigger? Centimeter is smaller, meter is bigger. So 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. Okay, when you change the unit from bigger to smaller, numerical value change from smaller to bigger. Okay, from here we get the relation between numerical value and unit. That is, numerical value is indirectly proportional to the 1 by unit means unit. Unit and numerical value are not directly proportional. They are indirectly proportional. Okay, up to this, let us discuss. And you all need to make the notes up to here.